Now we are going to say about the classification of Indian rivers. First point about the classification of Indian rivers is that Indian rivers are classified into two main types. The first one is the Himalayan rivers, and the second group of rivers are called the peninsular rivers. I repeat it once again, we are going to study about the classification of Indian rivers. So, accordingly, the Indian rivers are classified into two main types. The first one is the Himalayan rivers, and the second one is the peninsular rivers. Now, we are going to study about the first one, the Himalayan rivers. So, the Himalayan rivers are those rivers which originated from the Himalayan mountains. The Himalayan rivers are those rivers which originated from the Himalayan mountains. The first point. The second point is Himalayan rivers are also called as perennial rivers. Himalayan rivers are also called as perennial rivers. Why they are called as perennial rivers? Because they flow throughout the year. And Himalayan, as I already said, that Himalayan rivers are those rivers which originated from the Himalayan mountains. So, Himalayan rivers receive water, from melted snow. But from what? From the Himalayan mountains. Or in other words, we can say from the lofty mountains. Because we know Himalayan mountains are one of the largest mountain range in the world. And Himalayan mountains are also lofty mountains. So, the Himalayan rivers receive water from melted snow, that means from the lofty mountains, or you can say from the Himalayan mountains. Or Himalayan mountains receive water from rain, simply from rainfall. Now, the third point about the Himalayan rivers. In India, there are three main Himalayan rivers, and they all are major rivers. One, the Indus. Second one, the Brahmaputra. And third one, the Ganga. These are the examples of the Himalayan rivers. See? And the word Himalaya, it means the abode of snow. The word Himalaya means the abode of snow. And they are called as Himalayan rivers because they originated from the Himalayan mountains. And then second group of rivers. Now we will discuss about the second group of rivers, that is the peninsular rivers. Now look, peninsular rivers. First point about the peninsular rivers. The peninsular rivers are those rivers which are totally dependent on particular season. Belki monsoon season. Or we can simply say that's rainfall or the rainy season. I repeat it once again, the peninsular rivers are those rivers which are totally dependent on a particular season, that's monsoon season, or simply we can say that is rainfall. So sometimes peninsular rivers are also known as seasonal rivers. Seasonal rivers. Why peninsular rivers are also known as seasonal rivers? Because they dependent on a season, and that season is monsoon season. So that's why the peninsular rivers are also known as a seasonal rivers. Their flow, that's totally depend on monsoon season. And one of the main point about the peninsular rivers, that is, if we look at the map of India, here, this is the southern India. We can also say it's a peninsular India. Why? Because this is a peninsula. And we know peninsula is a piece of land which is surrounded by water, which is surrounded by water from three sides. And here, look, from the east, it is surrounded from the what? It is surrounded from the Arabian Sea. And from the west, it is surrounded from the Bay of Bengal. And at the bottom, from the south, it is surrounded from the Indian Ocean. So this piece of land is surrounded by water from three sides. This is the west, From west, it is surrounded from the Arabian Sea, and from the east, it is surrounded from the Bay of Bengal, and from the south, it is surrounded from the Indian Ocean. So this piece of land is known as a peninsula. So it is also known as a peninsular India. And those rivers which originated from the peninsular India are known as the peninsular rivers. Got it? So these rivers are also known as the peninsular rivers. And one of the points about the peninsular river is that is during dry season. During dry season, peninsular rivers reduce flow of water in their courses because they depend on a particular season, that's a monsoon season. So during the dry season, they reduce the flow of water in their channels. Now, in India, there are four major peninsular rivers. Six. First one is the Mahanadi River. Second one, the Godavari River. Third one is the Krishna River. And then fourth one is the Kaveri River. And also fifth one is the Narmada River. And sixth one is the Tapi. So these are the major six peninsular rivers. Now, on a second look at the peninsular India. Mahanadi River here, Godavari River, Krishna River, and Kali River. These four rivers are also known as East Flowing Rivers. East Flowing Rivers. Because simply they flow through the east. Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and the Kaveri are the east flowing rivers because they flow through the east. And the Narmada and Ritapi are the west flowing rivers. Simply because they flow through the west. So it's all about the Himalayan rivers and the peninsular rivers. Inshallah, in next lecture we will discuss separately. First about the Himalayan rivers, that's about the Indus River, the Ganga River and the Brahmaputra River. And after that we will discuss about the peninsular rivers, that's the Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, Narmada and the Tapi. Till then, Allah Hafiz.